Thank you. We'd like to do one called Paint It Black.
Hey everybody, it's Rich with Mustang Connection. Thank you so much for stopping by, and the car is already out of Mako. It was there a little over a week, and I thought I would walk around the car and show you how they did. Actually, pretty impressed. It is just a single stage, and the price was ridiculously low. So really, there's three elements to this in my mind. One is, how do they actually spray the car? Is there a lot of dirt, things like that? Because I had it prepped before I sent it in, and some of that prep work's evident. There's still some door dings and things like that, but nothing totally objectionable, and I'm gonna have to live with it because it is what it is at this point. But so in my mind, like I said, there's three kind of points to this. One would be obviously how'd they do, how was the actual coverage of the car. I think secondly, you know, how'd they tape things off, kind of the quality of the work above and beyond the paint itself, and then durability down the line, which will remain to be seen. So they told me I could probably color sand this thing in about 10 days. I'm gonna let it bake out in the hot California sun. It's gonna be warm the next week or so, very warm. And I am gonna try and color sand it, do a little 1500 to see how it does. And if it destroys it, it destroys it. I'm gonna roll the dice. But let me walk you around the car and you can check it out. So let's just kind of walk around the car and take a quick peek. As you can see, it's shiny now, that's for sure. Black, as you know, is the hardest color, one of the hardest colors to shoot when it comes to hiding bodywork. You're gonna really see everything, and that's basically what's happened now. The car has quite a few flaws, not necessarily paint wise. There's, you know, I would say there's no real drips, which is nice. There's a little bit of dirt in the paint in a couple of small areas, but for the most part, there's no drips. The coverage is very even. There's not a lot of orange peel for it being a single stage and in black. But there are quite a few door dings, as I mentioned, and that's really because the body guy that I had do the work didn't catch a few, and I really wasn't looking for like a concourse level thing. You really got to look for them. You can see them in here. There's a couple of door dings along this door and the rear quarter here. But in fact, there's one right here. It's pretty noticeable now. But look at the coverage. Pretty nice. Let me show you where the down in here looks like there's a little dirt in the paint on the side skirt here, but and I ended up having to leave the rear bumper with, and there was already a little bit of cracking. But look at the trunk, the rear deck lid, and they did paint the bumpers off. They did a nice job masking these off. These were those NOS tail lamps. They look really sharp in here. But there's no overspray at all onto the lens itself. They did a great job. So rear bumper is still off, as I mentioned. And yeah, they did a nice job. I have not started bolting everything back on. I just picked it up. And I need to get some more push pins, some of those Ford push pins. But you can see, look at the shine on it. Now again, a big part of this, and I see a little drip here. Sap already, but look how nice. And there's not a lot of overspray on stuff. All this stuff was taped off very well. There's a little bit right here, tiny bit. But I would say for a bargain paint job, Mako passed with flying colors. And like I said, they painted both bumpers off. The hood has great coverage. I think this will really shine up, assuming the 1500 doesn't just destroy the paint. But I have confidence. I'm gonna let this thing bake out in the sun for, like I said, about a week or so, and let it really come through. So. Look, they even took the little nostrils out on the hood. I didn't ask them to do that. They didn't even bother to tape it off. They actually took them out. So Mako, I'm gonna give you a thumbs up for this one. And no, Mako is not giving me anything to say this. I'm just throwing it out there that you can get a bargain paint job for a car that's not worth a lot if you're trying to do a little refresh. And that's the plan on this 95 GT, is to give it a refresh. That's it. and hope you enjoyed this SN95 update. Thanks for watching, and give me your feedback. Let me know what you think. See y'all soon.